biodiversité.
Biodiversity and blue planet.
Le terme est inventé par un écologue de la conservation.
The word was coined by an American ecologist in 1985. The blue planet is the history of life. Life is everywhere, and life was born in the ancestral ocean 3.85 billion years ago. Here we have pictures, one of the very first pictures taken by the Apollo mission. For the very first time, a human being in a small Apollo capsule could see the whole planet through a window. And he sees mainly ocean, the ocean that tells the history of life. Ocean is still there. And it covers 72% of the planet's area, but in terms of volume, it accounts for 90%, even more than 90% of the volume offered to life. But the ocean only harbors 13% of the known species. This is an important question. Ocean is made of water, so life appeared in water. And if we look at the fauna and the flora in the ocean, we have classified all animals in 33 main groups called phyla, and 12 groups have never left the ocean. They're still in the ocean nowadays. Life is connected with water. When life exits the ocean, exits water, it will endeavor to keep water inside the organism because it's not in the environment anymore. This is a picture of the Atacama Desert in Chile, the most desert in the world. It never rains, there are no bacteria, no intervertebrate. And every 10, 12 years, due to climatic events such as El Nino, it rains on the desert. And top right, you see that in a few days, the desert is covered in flowers. Imagine the flowers, the butterflies, the bugs, the birds that come to eat the insects. It goes on for 3 weeks, and after 3 weeks, everything stops. And for another 10 years, the desert becomes a desert again. At the bottom, you see a picture of human beings started watering a desert in Jordania and created a biological diversity. So water is life. All cells are made of water. And if water is so important, it's because it exists in under three forms. Ice, there is a lot of ice in the universe, vapor, and liquid water. And it's the fluid, the liquid water in a thermic range between 0 and 100 degrees Celsius that is indispensable. Before the DNA molecule, the first molecule is water. And here we have a tunisier and a jellyfish, 98% of water, and a date seed, the driest on Earth, just a few percent of water. But water is absolutely vital, and it's at the heart of all the environmental issues. Biodiversity must be placed among the main issues that we're looking at today. Energy, water, biodiversity, we're going to discuss that, climate, with possible interactions, all kinds of pollutions due to human activity, and interaction between human and the planet. Here on the planet, we have bacteria. And this young woman here lives in Madagascar, in a small island that belongs to the museum, and there's a natural reserve to protect lemurs. And one day we went to the reserve and we found that a family had settled down. We talked to those people, we loved them, they were nice, and we didn't want to kick them out of the island. They've walked 800 kilometers, they find themselves on a small island where there were no human beings, they have to leave. But this is a fundamental matter, the interaction between human beings and biodiversity. We can't separate the human being from biodiversity. We are part of the biodiversity. Biodiversity, what is biodiversity? Here we have a picture of a meteorite that fell in the southern France a long time ago, and it tells the story of how the sun came to be and the earth came to be. 4.6 billion years, the meteorite went around the solar system for billions of years, it fell in the field, it was collected, it came to a museum, and it was analyzed and dated. And on previous biodiversity in the ancestral ocean, 3.85 billion years, living life appears, and biodiversity appears when the very first cell starts dividing into two daughter cells, and progressively this is life appearing in the ocean. Here we have two ecosystems. On the right-hand side, we have coral reef in South America, 5,000 or 6,000 living species on a square kilometer, the richest wealth of human living organisms. And we have 1/3 of the species in the ocean in the coral reef. And here we have a tropical forest, Congo, Rwanda, and Uganda, between those three countries, the last places where gorilla can be found, 50,000 species for a square kilometer, 2 million known species, 1.7 on continents versus oceans, and three ecosystems now. First of all, a drop of seawater. I'm a sailor, so I love it. Billions of viruses and bacteria for each drop, protozoas, macrofauna, macroflora, fungi. This is highly important. We have to think about the diversity in the ocean. On the next picture, we have ground land, 2.5 tons of bacteria per hectare, 3.5 tons of mycelium, fungi, tardigrades, worms, nematodes, dust mites. And the ground is very interesting, 13% of the known species in the ocean, 23% in the land. And the third ecosystem is the digestive tube of a human baby at birth. You see the bacteria in the genital tract of the mother, and the bacteria will contaminate the baby and settle down in his digestive tractus. It takes 2 years for stabilizing of the bacteria, and we have found thousands of species of bacteria, 1,000, 2,000, and we only know 500 of them. So on an ecosystem so close to ours, a baby, we don't even know 1/4 of the species present in the digestive tractus. And here we have another picture of biodiversity. For a Frenchman, well, I'm always very successful abroad when I show the picture. Apart from the glass, the metal, and the cloth, everything else is biodiversity. What would French people be without their cheese, bread, and wine? There are dust mites, yeasts, and bacteria involved here, and this is tribute to biodiversity. Biodiversity is a living fraction of nature in all of its complexity.